Remember when you were 12 or 13 and you promised yourself that you would get rich by 24, have a car by 25, have a house by 26, and settle down and live your best life at 30? What year was that? 2012? 1999? Yeah, sure. And what year is it now? 2024? Wow, look at you. Still broke. What happened though? All those dreams and enthusiasm for nothing. How is it that it's 2024 and you're still broke? Well, it's not the universe playing pranks on you. It's you playing pranks on yourself. I mean, sure, there's inflation and nobody ever told you in high school or college to make money. But it's also you who has poor spending habits. Welcome to Financial Literacy. Here, we are dedicated and passionate about bringing you nothing but honest and straightforward facts about your money. We will help you take control of your finances and get you to the next level. Beginners or experienced, this is your one-stop shop for all things financial literacy. Here are your 6 habits keeping you poor. And oh, if you're not subscribed yet, why? You're definitely missing out. Number 1. Forgetting the power of small things. Ever heard the saying, "The small things matter"? No, not in your relationships. I mean, with your money. Let me translate it for you. Those seemingly harmless $5 daily iced oat latte with extra caramel drizzle coffees, daily boba runs, and that oh so cute but totally useless desk cactus you needed. Yeah, those seemingly insignificant purchases are low-key the gremlins of your bank account, sabotaging your financial future with every swipe. We've all been there. That voice in your head whispers, "It's just a few bucks. You deserve it." But those few bucks here and there quickly multiply into a financial monster. Think of it like neglecting a tiny crack in your phone screen. It might seem insignificant at first, but eventually, it renders the whole thing useless. The same goes for your finances. Ignoring small expenses can lead to bigger problems down the road. Skipping that daily latte or resisting the urge to buy the latest gadget might seem like a sacrifice now. But trust us, your future self will thank you 1,000 times. Every dollar saved today is a dollar invested in your long-term goals. Number 2. You are oh so heavy on FOMO. FOMO is not just a social media thing. It's so real. You see your friend's awesome trip pictures on social media or hear your coworker bragging about their brand new phone. Suddenly, you feel like you're missing out, and that feeling can lead to some serious budget trouble. Here's why. The everyone else is doing it trap. You don't have to follow suit just because it looks like everyone else is purchasing the newest technology or taking opulent trips. The need to keep up with the times might result in impulsive purchases that break your bank and make you feel even worse off. Another thing is comparing your backstage to their highlight reel. Social media is full of people showcasing the best parts of their lives. Remember that amazing vacation your friend posted about might have put them in debt. And that new phone your coworker got might not actually be the best fit for their needs. Don't compare your real life to someone else's carefully curated online persona. You don't need to spend a ton of money to have a good time. Missing out on fun doesn't mean missing out on life. Number 3. You have an education phobia. Financial literacy isn't some clickbait headline promising weird life hacks. It's the ultimate life hack that unlocks financial freedom. Imagine your finances as a complex video game. Winging it with random button mashing might work for a while, but eventually, you will get stuck at the boss level. Financial literacy equips you with the skills and knowledge to navigate the financial landscape, make informed decisions, and avoid costly mistakes. Listen, learning doesn't have to feel homework. There are tons of free resources available online, from bite-sized articles to engaging podcasts. Find a learning style that fits you, whether it's chilling with financial YouTubers or following relatable finance influencers on social media. Financial knowledge is power. The more you learn, the more confidence you will feel in managing your money. Number 4. You're hanging out with the wrong people. All right, let's talk about bad advice. You know, the kind you get from people who haven't exactly conquered their own goals yet. Here's the thing. Would you trust your financial future to a friend who is broke? Probably not. Successful people have blazed a trail, a path paved with lessons learned and victories won. Following their footsteps doesn't mean copying every post on their social media, but it gives you a roadmap. So, how do you avoid the self-proclaimed life guru and find a real mentor? Look for results, not just a fancy website and a million followers. Someone who's crushed it in your field is more likely to have insights beyond good vibes only and inspirational quotes with questionable grammar. Here's the bottom line. Your mentors matter. Surround yourself with winners who are winning in the areas you want to win. Success whispers secrets, but not always through inspirational posters with glitter backgrounds. Listen for the voices with real experiences. Number 5. You think it's not your fault. Let's face it, playing the blame game is a favorite pastime for many folks struggling financially. You blame your boss, your salary, the economy, anything you can see. You blame everyone but yourself. But blaming everything and everyone else but yourself isn't going to pay your bills. The truth is, financial freedom comes from taking responsibility. It's not about feeling bad, it's about taking control. Do you want a better financial future? You gotta be the hero of your own story. Taking responsibility might feel yucky, but it's like cleaning your room. It might not be fun, but it feels great in the end. Life isn't a movie where you're the helpless character. You can change your story. Blaming others is a very bad habit you need to break. You gotta start taking charge of your life and money. And number 6, you can only do one thing. Knowing just one skill is not enough. The truth is, financial security and career fulfillment thrive on versatility. The more diverse your skill set, the wider the doors you fling open to opportunity. It's not about abandoning your strengths. Those killer Excel macros are impressive, but rather about building a robust toolbox filled with complementary skills. The good news? Learning is no longer a luxury reserved for classrooms. The digital age has transformed education into a readily accessible buffet of knowledge. We're talking coding boot camps that can turn you into a website architect. If you're artistic, then graphic design courses can help to make your presentations pop. Be a digital artist and be open to commissions or even data analysis training to transform your Excel skills into strategic insights. All you need is a curious mind and a decent internet connection. After all, wouldn't it be empowering to be the master of your own career destiny? Whew, that was a real roller coaster ride of emotions, wasn't it? Remember, these habits and mindsets are what's stopping you from becoming rich. It is about high time that you change these. And as always, thank you for watching. If you want to see more, hit that subscribe button to get notified of our latest videos.